Do you want to take your audio from sounding like this? I don't know if this will work, but this is me playing wind noise. To sounding like this.
The wind noise is still playing. As you can see, it's pretty limited compared to before.
Without any technical sound mixing skill whatsoever, in seconds, for free, sounds too good to be true, right? Sounds. Well, stick around because I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. Now, for filmmakers, audio is one of the hardest things to get right. It's why people like this exist. And it's also why audio equipment is so freaking expensive.
£550 for this.
And for solo creators like me, for whom it's pretty much impossible to monitor audio, it is just a really difficult thing to get right. So if that's you, I bet you filmed an entire segment of a video, or maybe an entire video, or maybe even an entire series of videos.
The audio is all distorted, and this is 4 days worth of filming. Why?
And you've not realised that the audio is bad. Maybe there's echo, interference, wind noise, someone's left the aircon on, a fan, something happens in the background. All these things contribute to the perception we want to avoid, and that is the perception that we don't care about audio, but that's just not true, is it? Here's where we welcome Adobe Podcast, and in particular, their Audio Enhance tool, which is free online, available at the link below. You need an Adobe account to do this, but you do not need a paid Creative Cloud account. And it is literally as easy to use as this. Step one, export your bad audio in a WAV or MP3 format from your editing software of choice. Step two, drop it into your browser. Not straight into your browser, go to the link, then drop it into your browser. Step three, wait. Step four, download the good audio file. Step five, import the new audio file back into your timeline. That's it, you've fixed it. Go home, well done, you're finished here. So if you're in Premiere Pro, the easiest way of doing this is to export your audio as a WAV file, as I'm showing you here. I did this in my last video and I exported a 13-minute long audio file. Now make sure you just export that track and you don't include any of the music or sound effects that you might be using. You just want the voice track. Drag it into the browser, let the tool do its work, and then once it's given you a download back, download it and then pull that back in to your timeline and overwrite your existing audio. That's literally it. So good, it feels like there should be a catch. And there is, kind of. You're still going to need to record fairly decent audio. You cannot get away with being sloppy. It's good, this tool, but it can't work miracles. So if you've got wind barreling into the microphone, it's going to struggle to pull the vocals out of that as clearly as you want it to. So it's key to maintain good practice when capturing your audio. This tool just lets you have a bit of leeway. Best practice is still to be encouraged. So use a wind buff when you're outside. Make sure your levels are correct when you're recording into camera or into your audio device. Just keep doing the things you should do and let this kind of be a backup more than anything else, or a slight enhancer as I've done to remove the echo
like this.
As a final example, this is me recording audio on my onboard camera mic, something that should be avoided at all costs. This little tiny thing here, and the audio is pretty bad. But if I put it through the Enhance tool...
Hopefully now you will be hearing how much this tool can improve your audio. Quite astonishing.
Hopefully this will be really useful to a lot of filmmakers and creators out there. And if it's been useful to you, I'd really appreciate it if you'd give this video a thumbs up. And please hit subscribe if you'd like to hear more from my life as a filmmaker, photographer, and creative business person. Thanks ever so much for watching. Until next time.